Can you hear it? These mugs are no longer clay, they are now ceramic, and they're ready to be glazed. But first, they're going to need a sponge bath. A sponge bath will get rid of the layer of dust that's on top of your mug. The dust can mess up the glaze, so make sure you take a wet sponge and wipe down all parts of your mug, including the inside and the handle. After you've washed your mug, you're ready to choose your first glaze color. I'm going to go with a Fantasia glaze. Now this glaze looks red, but make sure you pay attention to the picture on the label, because after it comes out of the kiln, it's gonna look like that bluish green color. And that's because of the chemical changes that will happen when that glaze gets up to around 2000 degrees. To paint your glaze on your mug, first you have to get your work area set up. Place your mug on top of a piece of newspaper and make sure you have a brush. Now we're ready to begin painting. You need to paint the inside of your mug, the inside of the handle, all parts except for the very bottom of your mug. No glaze down there. If you put glaze on the bottom of your mug, it can cause your mug to stick in the kiln. Once you've decided on your glaze color for your first layer, open up the glaze and begin stirring it up. Make sure you stir your glaze from the bottom, and it should end up being the consistency of a milkshake you could drink through a straw. About like that. That looks good. Just a little bit thicker than milk. Now if you end up looking at some glaze and it looks like mashed potatoes, it's too thick. If your glaze is too thick, just put a sip of water, one little sip, and mix that in until it's the consistency of a milkshake you could drink with a straw. Once your glaze has a good consistency, you can begin painting it. Take your brush, dip it in the glaze, and begin making back and forth brush strokes on your cup. Make sure you have enough glaze on your brush. If you don't actually have much on your brush at all, you'll end up with a very thin layer like that. And that won't be enough glaze for it to actually turn glossy when we put it in the kiln. On the flip side of that, you also don't want to paint with too much glaze on your brush. It'll make a big mess, you'll end up with drips and wasting glaze onto your newspaper, and this can also create a layer of glaze that is too thick and can actually melt off your cup in the kiln. Just use a reasonable, medium amount of glaze on your brush at a time and scrape any extra glaze on your brush off against the lid of the glaze container. Paint all parts of your mug, including the inside and the handle, until you cannot see any of the clay itself, except at the very bottom of your mug, which you don't want to paint at all. Once you finish your first layer, let the glaze dry until it looks and feels dry and powdery. You'll notice little chunks in your glaze. They look like little rocks. These are little hunks of colored glass that will melt and explode into a color burst on the side of your mug when they go into the kiln. So leave those on there. And now I'm ready for my second layer of glaze. I could do another layer of Fantasia, but I'm gonna add some variety by going for this buttercup yellow. Remember to stir your glaze up and make sure that it has the consistency of a milkshake. And then begin painting another layer across the entire mug. The inside, the handle. The only thing you don't need to paint is the very bottom. And then let it dry. Your second layer will take longer to dry than your first did. And you can really start to see those little chunks of colored glass. Once your second layer is dry, you're ready for your third and final layer. I'm going to use a raspberry colored glaze for my last layer. You have to get 3 layers of glaze on your mug for it to turn glossy in the kiln. If you only get 2, the glaze will never turn into that glassy look. It will just stay in this chalky, powdery state. So I'm going to use the glaze. I'm going to make sure I get over my entire mug, using a medium amount of glaze on the brush at a time so that it's not too sloppy or too thin. When your third layer is complete, you can take your brush and scrape it. We don't want to waste any of that glaze, so scrape as much as you can back into the glaze cup. Cap it. Put your brush in the sink. Straighten your newspapers back up into a stack.
Please come to the front office.
And you'll be done for the day. All right, guys, let's get to glazing.